what's next. It's a matter of what's now and how you're going to choose to live your life in the moment, because that's all you ever have. And you can only decide what side you're on when you realize that the fight for liberty is a fight to progress humanity to the next phase of our evolution. It's not about whether you're going to win this victory or that. It's for you as an individual to decide what side you're going to be on.
Bitcoin.
You want to talk about Bitcoin?
Talk about whatever you want.
Well, you guys, I'm speaking tomorrow, right? Like,
hey, if you want to say this, we need this. We can talk about it.
We're quiet now.
About you know, the way state is state government. I didn't answer that nagging question that something was wrong. And I don't know what it is. I have a theory that I'm probably going to make a video about and upload private on YouTube and not such a public for like a year. Because it's one of those theories. But there's this whole thing that I got that explains everything. But the fact that you need an explanation for Ron Paul is a sign of your own emotional passion. And I think the lesson that the movement is taking away from us is really powerful. And I think, if anything, especially with the conversation that's happening here at Conference, a lot of people are moving on with a better vision of the movement. Because you go to, like, you go to Ron Paul and you start going down the rabbit hole and you study the Constitution. And the Constitution is like a snag on the way down, you know, to voluntarism. And even Ron's a voluntarist, but he talks about a practical constitutional problem, right? That's moving us in the right direction. And I totally respect that. I buy that. And I think that's an important form of activism. But it's a snag on the way down the rabbit hole. And you might become a voluntarist or an anarcho capitalist and be like, I'm at the bottom of the rabbit hole. But you know what? No, you're not. Because the real libertarian rabbit hole, it doesn't have a bottom. And it keeps going. And that's why all you can ever do anyways is live in the moment and know what side you're on. And that's why my understanding that I've developed myself about human history is so important for me in maintaining my sanity and being able to get out and do this every day. Is this the therapy session now? I kind of came here expecting people to be mad at me, and people are understanding, and everybody's like on the same page.
It's really hard. You've done so much for the movement.
I guess.
They bring up to me, it's something I've said to people. I said in one of our meetings in Alaska, that was one of the core meetings of people, where I said this, and I know a lot of people especially like it. I've said it a few times, I'm going to say it again. This isn't about Ron Paul. This is so much bigger than Ron Paul. Ron Paul understands that, accepts that.
Yeah.
You know, and the bottom line is this is about humanity, not one human. You know,
I don't think he even sees it. I think, if anything, it's like he comes from a different era. And there's those things.
That's it.
And, you know, I really love older libertarians. Because, what? No.
She's in Texas. She's an older libertarian on Facebook. All of you find Judy Morris on Facebook. She's a rock star libertarian.
Judy Morris?
Yeah.
Judy Morris.
She's from Texas. Her picture's her and Dr. Paul. She's got a blog that she's in it to win it. She's awesome.
But when like, I interviewed an 11 and a 12-year-old boy here together who were at a Bruce campaign. I don't want to call them boys because they're like, they're young men at 11 and 12 years old that have this perspective, like, and about older libertarians, like, I'm talking to them like, all right, so you were born into $40,000, $50,000 is your share of the federal debt. How does that make you feel? You know this, and you got 7 years to get ready for when you get allowed to vote, you know? And for the people that don't have that incentive, the people especially that woke up later in life and are going, I got an obligation because I see that something is wrong here, and I contributed to this, and I can do something to make it better, and I'm going to sacrifice for that, and I'm not going to get to see the fruits of that, but I'm going to choose to be on this side of the struggle. That's really cool. And in that sense, I have a particular appreciation for the older people that woke up later in life. Because you can wake up later in life and be like, fuck it, I'm out of here in a bit anyways. Let it go to hell. You know? And then people say, no, like, I really care about the future of humanity. Not my future, the future of humanity after I'm gone. And that's really cool, seeing that here as well. And so, but Ron Paul, I don't think he has that perspective that the millennial generation. I got the 30s. And I like to think that I grew up with the internet. Since literally, as it was developing, it was growing up. And there are a lot of people in the older generations who are, you know, adapters. So no matter what new technology comes on, they'll pick it up, they'll get it. But for those of us that really went through developing our sense of identities as adults, as humans, with the internet, there's a totally different expectation about the world. And I thought, like, it was going to be my generation. I was like, no way. It's those guys who are 11 and 12 right now who are going to high school, who know what Cop Block is, who are fans of Adam versus the Man, who know about the School Sucks Project, who are going into this with, like, this kind of awareness. They're going and they're about to get fed all this propaganda, and they've got the truth button in their pockets, and they know how to use it. Like, that's the future. And in a way, I look at the political conversation that's going on right now, feel it? You feel like the breeze on your face now? Is it like coming faster and faster and faster? Well, guess what? It's about to get faster and faster and faster, and you have no idea what's coming. Not a real reason. But if that's your faith in this message you can see, then we're going to evolve past government technologies to help us do it. And to do it more than
this is a part of that, the government is going to be rendering obsolete
in a matter of decades.
Take that step, and it's
I'm like, isn't Alaska
state
practically voluntary already?
Well, that's what I'm saying. It's funny because I'm calling this other people because it's a free state project.
We're Alaska.
Free state project.
Yeah.
Bring all of you,
and I'll do it 10 times.
We still got land. We're okay. Yeah, we got everything you can possibly need. Just bring a scarf.
New Hampshire loves their libertarians.
We got unincorporated land for the size of New Hampshire near my island. It's just like, it's right over there.
I'm not moving to fucking New Hampshire because it's too warm. I figure by the time I'm ready to homestead, all that will be irrelevant. I'm going to go to Arizona, Mexico, you know, build an Earthship.
You only hit 140 inches of
okay, I know you got to get some food, and I got to get my delegate meeting. You guys got more questions? I got to go, actually.
No, I'm good.
Hey, thank you very much, man. It was a pleasure to meet you. And one more thing. Yeah, I forgot, yeah. Yeah, come on, boys.
Here, I'll pay you guys.